Before we jump into the Interactive Reports tab at the top of the screen, I want to quickly cover the other tabs. The Reports tab will house reports pertaining to the AQI, such as monitoring plans. The Health Impacts tab has useful information about the AQI. The Publications tab has documents that relate to the sampling and analysis of air quality parameters. The Resources tab provides links to other air quality websites. And finally, the Contact Us tab has our email address for questions or comments about the AQI. Going back to the Interactive Reports tab, three of the options allow you to visualize data, while the rest allow you to query and report data. The Hourly Monitoring Data option allows you to select any parameter at a station to view as either a bar chart or line graph. You can select multiple parameters per station or parameters at multiple stations to view in this way. Clicking the up arrow or X near the upper left of the graph or chart will close the graph. You can export all of the hourly data for the date you're currently viewing by clicking the PDF icon in the upper right corner. The Pollutant Rows option allows you to create a wind rose and compare it with pollutant results using the same format. If you want to include a pollutant, be sure to check the Report with Pollutant checkbox. You can customize the monitoring locations, number of sectors, report type, max value, number of classes, and date range. It is important to note that the max value and number of classes will be the same for both the wind rows and pollutant rows, so be sure to pick a max value that works for both wind speed and your pollutant. Once the rows plots are made, you can export them as images or Excel files. It's also important to note that the wind rows indicates the direction the wind is blowing from. The Custom Graphs option allows you to select one or more pollutants. Just hold Control, then click Additional Pollutants. You can also choose a monitoring location and statistics site for a set date range or a custom range of dates. The data is then displayed as a line graph, which can be exported as an image. The other five options, which are Station Report, Stations Report, Monitor Report, Automatic Data, and Annual Exceedance, work in a similar fashion to the Customs Graph page. I want to point out a feature of the Stations Report, so let's use that as an example. Fill out the information on the left-hand side of the screen. When you get to the Stations selection box, notice that each station has a little plus sign by it. This means that you can expand the station's options and select one or more of the parameters monitored at that location. You also have the option to select a set range of dates or a custom range of dates across the top. So if you're interested in PM 2.5 data from the Columbia Gorge over the last month, you can set your query to pull that specific data. A report is created for each station selected with summary statistics for your period of time near the top. By default, the report gives you a tabular version of the hourly data below those stats. You can change this to a bar chart or line graph, or export the station's data as an Excel file. Note, this will only export or graph the data from that specific monitoring location. As I mentioned before, the other report types work in a similar fashion. If you have any questions on anything we've covered in this tutorial, please email aqm.questions@deq.state.or.us. Also, be sure to check out the Oregon Air mobile app, which has all of the functionality of the desktop version of this map. The app is available for free in the Google Play and iTunes stores. That concludes this tutorial on the Air Quality Index. Thank you for watching.